Since 1886, the statue has been well known as an incredible work of art, an amazing feat of engineering. She stands at a whopping 305 feet and 1 inch above the ground and has faced record-breaking winds of over 113 miles per hour from Hurricane Hazel in 1954. So how does this colossal statue withstand the test of time? What you may not know is, inside the Statue of Liberty, there is a mini Eiffel-like tower. It doesn't look exactly like the Eiffel Tower in France. However, it was created by the same person and has a very similar profile. The design basically resembles a modern electrical tower. Alexander Gustav Eiffel engineered the structure to be flexible using a method called curtain wall construction. Attached to the 97-foot iron tower rising above the pedestal is a system of flat bars supporting 1,830 stainless steel armature bars to the statue's copper panel exterior. This is all held in place by copper saddles. That same iron tower is also connected to tie rods, which attach to tension bars inside the granite pedestal. There are gaps in between the armature bars and the copper skin. This enables the saddles to allow the copper plates to suspend from the tower. The flat bars work as springs and cause kinetic energy to travel downward through the statue, absorbing into the pedestal walls. It sounds confusing, but it actually all works out. Think of it like this. Movement in the statue is much like the curtains hung in your home. The statue's copper plates are draped in a way to sustain wind resistance and give her the ability to sway. Wind speeds pushing 50 miles per hour or more cause the statue to move up to 3 inches off center and the torch up to 6 inches off center. She was over-engineered by today's standards and was considered state-of-the-art technology in 1885. Because of Eiffel's cracked design, the Statue of Liberty is able to stand proudly on a windy day.